Hello children, how are you all? Let's continue with our chapter 2, whole numbers. Last video we have learnt about closure property and commutative property. Let's continue with more property, the third property, associative property. To associate means to connect or join with something. Let's learn this with few examples. Here you can see that we are adding a few numbers, like three numbers, that is 2 + 5 + 3. Now in the first calculation, you can see that I have made a group of 5 and 3, and then the answer of 5 and 3, I am adding to 2. So the product is 10. But in the other calculation with the same numbers, but my group is different. I have changed the group. Here I have made a group of 2 and 5, and the sum of 2 and 5 I am adding to 3. So here also the answer is 10. Now let's see one more example. 11 plus 6 plus 9. Here I have first made a group of 6 and 9, and then the sum I am adding to 11, which is 26. Now in the other calculation, I have made the group of 11 and 6 first, and then sum I am adding to 9. Then also we are getting the same answer. According to associative property of addition, the sum of 3 or more numbers remains the same regardless of how numbers are grouped. Means your grouping is the way you can do the grouping. Either you make the group of first few numbers and then the other numbers. So here it means grouping is not affecting the answer. So this example shows that when adding three numbers or more numbers, it does not matter which two numbers are added first. So this property is called the associativity of addition. Now we say that the whole numbers are associative under addition. Thus, if A, B and C are whole numbers, then A can be added to the group of B and C. Is the answer is same to the group when we add the C to the group of A and B. Now let us see that this property of associativity is true for multiple or not. Now let's observe few examples for multiplication also. Here I am multiplying 2 with 7 and 6. Now in first calculation, I have made the group of 7 and 6, and then the product I am multiplying with 2, which gives me a final answer 84. With the same numbers, only the group is changed. Instead of the group of 7 and 6, I have made the group of 2 and 7. Now 2 and 7, that is 2 sevens are 14, is multiplied with 6 also gives the same answer 84. Now let's see one more example where I have first made the group of 11 and 8, and then the product of 11 and 8, that is 88, I am multiplying with 9, which gives me product 792. Now with the same numbers, I have just changed the group. In the first calculation, I have made the group of 11 and 8. Now, in the second way, I am making the group of 8 and 9. So, here the group of 8 and 9 will multiply and its product will multiply with 11. So, here 11 is multiplying with the product of 8 and 9, which is 72. And the final answer is 792. So, here you can say that the associative property of multiplication allows us to group factors in different ways to get the same product. The product is the same, only the grouping is different. So, when we multiply the first number with the product of second and third, or we multiply the third number with the product of first two. So, we say that the whole numbers are associative under multiplication. Thus, if A, B and C are whole numbers, then A multiplied by B multiplied by C means A multiplied with the product of B and C is equals to when C multiplied with the product of A and B. So, here we can understand that this associativity of addition and multiplication is very useful in the process of simplification using addition and multiplication. Let us now learn about our next property, distributivity of multiplication over addition. Now, what is distributive property? So, here you can say the distributive property lets you multiply a sum by multiplying each addends separately and then add the product. Now let us understand by these given examples, where you can see in the first calculation 22 is multiplied with the sum of 7 and 5, which is 12. So 22 multiplied by 12, the product is 264. Now the same calculation is done with the usage of distributive property. Now you can see here the addends, which is 7 and 5, are multiplied separately with the factor 22. So here 22 multiplied by 7, the product is 154. We are adding to the product of 22 multiplied by 5, which is 110. And then the sum of both the products, which is 264. Now, what is the use of this distributive property? So, here you can understand or you can see that the distributive property is an easy rule which you need for all your future math magic, or it helps you with the simplifying an equation and a simplifying expression. Whenever you come across a sum or a difference which is inside the parenthesis means bracket. So here you can see that 7 and 5 is in the bracket. So you have come across the situation where you have to add and then you have to multiply. So in this situation, distributive property makes and helps us to make our calculation easy. So by multiplying the factors with the addends which are there in the bracket. So from the above examples, we see that in both the situation, like in the first calculation, 22 multiplied by 7 and the sum of 7 and 5, but is equals to the multiplication of 22 with the 7 and 22 with the 5, and then you are adding the product of it, it will give you the same answer, means ultimately it is the same. So this property is called the distributivity of multiplication over addition, and this is true for all whole numbers. Now let us learn this with one more example. See the example where 235 is multiplied with the 421. So what I do is, instead of multiplying in a normal way, I am separating the, or I am expanding the number 421. So its expanded form is 400 plus 20 plus 1. So now what I'll do is, 235, I'll first multiply with 400. 235 I'll also multiply with 20, and 235 I'll multiply with the 1. It means I'll multiply 235 with the 400, with the 20, and with the 1, one by one, and then I'll add the product of all three calculation, and I'll get the product, which is 98,935. Now multiply the way you have multiplied in the earlier classes, the same calculation. When you see the number, the thought comes in your mind is this multiplication pattern, that okay, let's multiply in a simple way, which is 235 multiplied by 421. So here you can see that 235 I have multiplied with 1, that is 1's place, then 235 I'll multiply, second calculation when I do with the 2, it is same as you are multiplying 235 with the 20, then the third calculation means third answer, which is the 100's place, when you multiply, it is the same as you are multiplying 235 with the 400. So ultimately you are doing the same calculation, only the thing is we are looking and doing it differently. Actually, if you believe or not, directly, indirectly, we were using distributive property in our earlier classes also, and now also we are understanding it with the name distributive property. So the multiplication process that you have been followed earlier is nothing but the application of distributive property of multiplication over addition. So what, as we have learned that, or as we have discussed, that distributive property is helpful or useful in making our calculation easy and quick. Now let us learn about the identity for addition and multiplication. Now observe the example, the given below, that when you add any whole number with the zero, for example 255, you are adding with 0, the answer will remain the same. Means when you get the sum of 0 and any of the whole numbers, the answer will remain the same number. It does not change the value. So when we add 0 to any whole number, the result is the same number. So we can say that 0 is called an identity for addition of whole numbers. Or you can also say that additive identity for whole numbers means you can say 0 is an identity for whole numbers, or identity for addition of whole numbers, or you can say 0 is an additive identity of whole numbers. Now let's see few more examples. Now if you see this examples, in this examples we are multiplying 55 with 1. So the answer, when we are finding the product of 55 and 1, it will remain the same number. If you see the below example, you are multiplying 1 with the 7, which leaves you with the same number, no change in the number. So here you can say that when any whole numbers is multiplied with 1, the product is the same whole number. So here we can say that 1 is the identity for multiplication of whole numbers, or multiplicative identity for whole numbers. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe. We'll meet again.